Hey everybody, this is Houston, also known as Gurf Gurston or Hurtface or whatever you want to call me. Basically making this video because I'm exhausted. I'm tired of doing the Gurf videos, and I'm tired of just making these kinds of videos. If you've been watching the channel lately, I've been kind of on a manic video uploading making spree. And I don't want to be that person anymore. I don't want to do Gurf videos anymore. I don't want to do this crazy weird stuff. I'm at a point now where I don't really want to do that kind of these kinds of videos anymore. It's been a really tough time for me personally, and I don't know, the videos lately, they haven't been really fun to make anymore, and I want to venture out into other kinds of projects. I'd like to do some writing. I'd like to really learn some photography. I'd like to do more video art kind of stuff. And if this makes anyone upset, I know it'll probably make a lot of people happy, because there's a lot of people that really just do not like Gurf videos, and there's a lot of people who do, but that's just not where my head's at anymore. And I'm gonna be taking a long break from doing this crap. It's not who I am anymore, and it's not who I want to be anymore. And so if that makes you upset, I'm really sorry. But that's just the way it is. There will be some new things up on the channel one day, but as of right now, I don't have time for it. I don't want to do it anymore. I really don't. And I don't know. It's a new chapter in my life, you know. I'm trying to change. And I think this is just not good for my headspace, making these Gurf videos. I want to do something else. Anything else. I just don't know what it is yet. If you're still watching, thank you. And I'm out.
The line between Gurf the character and my personal life and me as a person started to become blurred. He started to kind of... I was having trouble separating myself from Gurf, almost as if he was real, a real person. And it started to worry me a little bit. Because as you all know, I have officially quit making Gurf videos. And sometimes at night, I'm sleeping and I can hear Gurf talking to me, saying all kinds of weird stuff, and I feel almost not whole without Gurf around. Because, you know, Gurf's dead. Thank you.
Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and this is another episode of Bedtime Movie Review Show. This is a show where I review a movie. I review new movies that are out because no one on the internet has thought about making a show where they review movies. It's a totally original idea that I came up with. Actually, you know what? I didn't come up with it. It's what everyone on the internet does. They review movies or review video games and stuff. And I figured, hey, I'm not really getting anywhere by making anything original, so why not just do what everybody else does? I give up on trying to do my own thing or try to be innovative. You do that and everyone calls you a weirdo. So the movie I'm gonna be reviewing tonight is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2. Out of the Shadows. And it's weird that the movie is called Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2 Out of the Shadows, because my Uncle Larry used to play a game with me when I was a kid. I'd be at his house and he'd turn all the lights off in the house, and it would be nighttime and it'd be pitch black, and so I couldn't see anything. And Uncle Larry would, you know, he'd go to the kitchen and he'd throw, like, spatulas at me and pans at me from all different directions. And I couldn't see anything, and it hurt so bad. And he'd turn the light on. He'd turn all the lights back on, and he'd be naked. So, anyways, let's get back to the review of the new Ninja Turtles movie. It's kind of hard for me to review movies these days because I've been banned from the local theater. I went there not too long ago to see the new, Captain America movie, and I had a scab on my knee, and I kept picking at the scab and just picking at it until I just ripped the scab off. But I didn't stop there. I kept ripping off skin from my knee to my leg, and there was blood everywhere, and the guy sitting next to me started freaking out about it and being a little sis boom and had me kicked out of the theater. So whenever I do go to the local theater, I have to wear a fake beard over my beard, and, you know, people just tend to get out of my way as soon as they see me anyway. Also, I have a really pungent smell, so people just try to stay away from me. So nobody knows that I'm not supposed to be in the theater and I'm there anyway. As far as the movie goes, I didn't see the first Ninja Turtles movie because I'm not a buffoon. And also because I'm not five, it was kind of sad that there were actually a lot of, like, 30-year-old dudes in the theater, and they were, like, you know, being all nerdy, and they were like,
I hope this is as good as Ninja Turtles from when I was a kid.
Well, I got news for you, it's not going to be that good, because you're 30. You're not a kid anymore. And life isn't fun anymore when you're not a kid. So you're probably not going to like the movie, you 30-year-old virgin piece of shit. I have a brain disorder that makes it impossible for me to be able to decipher CGI images. So whenever I see a movie with CGI in it, it just looks like a big, like, slimy mess. Like, none of the pieces fit together. So I didn't understand anything that was happening during the movie. It just was like a bunch of green blobs. So I give the movie 2 stars out of 5 stars because I didn't understand it. I don't understand anything. And it's not funny. Nothing about this is funny. Nothing about this YouTube channel's funny. I'm not funny. I don't have it in me anymore to do these videos. I keep telling the people that run this channel that I don't want to do videos anymore. But they keep saying, Gurf, we need you back because nobody cares about our other stuff. They want to see you, Gurf. I've lost everything because of these videos. I've lost girlfriends. I've lost jobs. I've lost my self-respect. I just want to be a decent human being. And then people keep emailing me, when are you going to make more videos? And I keep telling them that I'm not making videos anymore. And they keep asking me, and they keep asking me. Why should I have to be held prison to the internet? To these people on the internet who keep asking more and more from me? I don't have any more ideas for videos. I've run out of all my ideas. There's nothing left for... But I keep having to do it, and I sign these contracts, and there's all these lawyers involved, so I'm being forced to make these videos. I'm being forced to demean myself. And I don't like it. I don't like it. So if you're still watching this video, just stop. Tell everybody not to watch Gurf videos anymore. Or to ask for more Gurf videos, please. I can't do it anymore. I want to start building sailboats or something. Okay? Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and I'm just going to read an email that someone just sent me. Dear Gurf, could you please stop making videos? If you don't, I'm going to slit your throat. If I can't do that, then I'm going to fist you to death. Now listen, it doesn't matter what the letter says. It's not funny when you're threatening my life. It's not funny, all right? You know, it would be funny if it was happening to someone other than me, but when it's happening to me, it's not funny, okay? Listen, death threats, I don't need them, okay? I don't need them, I don't want them. I know I'm annoying, and I know nobody likes me, and I've got weird rashes on weird parts of my body, but that's no reason to be mean to me. This is the internet. The internet is made for people to have thoughtful discussions and to be nice and polite to each other. And so when I get letters like this, it really concerns me. I'm just a normal guy trying to have a normal life, and I don't need all this hatred. I'm a nice guy and I do a lot for society. Every year I donate $20 to dolphin charities around the globe. So if you could please, people, please stop sending me death threats.
Is this is them? Yeah, man. So outrageous and edgy. This has got to get a million views.
Hey everybody, welcome to a new episode of the Gurf Zone. This is going to be our wackiest episode yet. You're not going to believe what we're going to... I can't do it anymore. I can't make these videos anymore. I can't do it. Whatever happened to decency and loyalty? Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston. Enough with the wacky stuff. I want to tell everybody to please check out our new music site, cindyshade.bandcamp.com. And you can go there and you can download the new EP from Cindy Shade. Now, this is the first in a series of albums from Cindy Shade. It's a very short album. It's more like a prelude to stuff that's coming up. And it's only 99 cents. You can't beat that price. My dad could beat me all he wanted, but you can't beat that price. You just can't. You just can't! So cindyshade.bandcamp.com. All right, let's get that out of the way. I want to talk about making videos. I signed a contract stating that I have to make videos or I'll get sued. And I don't like making these videos anymore. I hate it. I'm making these videos against my will. And it's very scary. I the people that own this channel, they made me sign a contract saying you have to do so many videos. And I just don't like it. I get sweaty when I make videos and my rashes protrude from my skin, and it's just all around unhealthy. And then I gotta clean everything up after I'm done. I just don't like making videos. But they're forcing me to do it. There's people following me. I looked in my kitchen sink and I swear I saw an eyeball. It was probably Cheerios. But I'm pretty sure it was an eyeball. So, the only way to get them to let me stop making videos is if you guys stop requesting them. Stop asking for Gurf videos. Stop subscribing. We lost 10 subscribers this week because we kept putting up Cindy Shade videos. And people are like, what the hell is this crap? Well, and then we lost 10 subscribers, and that's what I want. If you're subscribed to this channel, unsubscribe. I want 0 subscribers. I don't want anyone watching my videos anymore. I want you to leave me alone. Please stop watching the channel. It's the only way they'll let me be free. Okay? Could you do that? Could you do it for the Gurf? All right, this has been a new episode of the Gurf Zone. Go to cindyshade.bandcamp.com. Download the album. It's a short album, but we're going to be working on the second. I made all the music. We're going to be working on the second Cindy Shade album, which is going to be a bigger album very soon. And we're also going to start restarting on the Gurf movie. So that's my dad. Action. Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and this is a behind-the-scenes look at how I make my videos.
a lot of people ask me, hey, Gurf, how do you... A lot of people ask me, hey, Gurf, how do you make your... A lot of people ask me, hey, Gurf, how do you make your videos? Well, today I'm going to show you, step by step, the process in making a Gurf video. Step number one, you need an idea. Because if you don't have an idea for a video, then what are you gonna film? You're not gonna film anything if you don't have an idea. The way I usually come up with my ideas is I lie down on the ground, close my eyes, and I think, what do people want from me? What's the next video? So let's take a look at the thinking process. Okay, after I'm done coming up with the ideas, then I have to write them down on a piece of paper. And it depends, you know, sometimes writing a Gurf episode can take a month, or it can take up to 3 weeks, you know, coming up with all the jokes, and with you know, what's going to happen here and there. A lot of thought goes into it. You know, and I like to write my scripts down on pen, with pen and paper. So let's take a look at the writing process. And after you're done writing, you gotta film it. Because if you film it, if you don't film it, how is anybody gonna watch your video? So let's take a look at the behind the scenes of the filming process. After you're done filming, obviously, you have to edit. Editing is the most funnest process of video making for me, because that's where I get to put all the puzzle pieces together. And a lot of people think I'm a really sloppy editor, and well, a lot of those people could suck a cock, because I'd like to see them do better editing wise. So let's take a look at the editing process. And so after a video is done being edited, then comes promotion. I have to put the video onto YouTube, and then I have to promote it. Promoting is a lot of fun if you like being called names, if you like people threatening your life, which happens to me every time I promote a video. And I pretend like it doesn't hurt my feelings, but it really hurts my feelings. And that's it. I'm out of.
that's when I saw you, and I flew down to your shoulder. You asked me what was wrong. I asked you why you were all alone. You gave no answer. I put my mouth to your ear and told you it was over. 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 It was over.
That's when she put the blade to my face. And she said, I don't care what you say, I'm gonna put every single one of my fingers in your mouth. And I had no choice. She had a knife. So I said, go ahead. And she proceeded to put her whole fist in my mouth.
Why do you keep telling me this story?
Shut the fuck up, Jeremy. Oh, crap. It's happening. Jeremy, it's happening. It's happening. My water just broke. Oh! The baby's coming! Smells like my dad. Are we gonna eat this fucking thing or what?
My name's Alvin Gurston, and I'm not scared of nothing. I ain't scared of no goddamn bears, I ain't scared of no goddamn chickens, I ain't scared of no goddamn fish. I like to take the heads of fish and cut them. Every time I try to go in the forest, there's three bears there trying to fuck me. But they don't fuck me, I put a bear in a headlock and I fuck it.
It's all bullshit, Jeremy. It's all bullshit. All of it. Think about it. I mean, what's the point? What does everyone want in life? They want to get married. They want to have kids. They want to buy a house. Well, you know what? You fall in love. You get married. Then you and your wife start bitching at each other. Then you have kids. The kids start growing up and they start doing drugs and fucking up and screwing everything up for you and being a big giant pain in the ass. Then you get a house. What's the point? And then you fucking die. Then you become an old man in your fucking diapers, dribbling with your spit dribbling down your wrinkled face like a big, giant, wet vagina. It's just... I'm rambling. That's not what I want in life. I want something more. I want something amazing. This can't be it. This bullshit can't be it. This can't be life. This can't be all that we're promised, Jeremy. It just can't. Jeremy, I need you to do something for me. Just a favor. Kid.
Can you just tell me I'm not crazy? Can you just tell me that? Can you tell me I'm not crazy? Could you please tell me I'm not crazy?
Prescribe myself. Doctors cannot help. The coldest winter that I've ever known. Don't ask me if I have a home. I don't know where I'm gonna sleep tonight. Under a bridge cold and in fright. I miss my family, I wish they'd take me back. I miss my family, how would they react if they saw my face? If they saw my face. There's a light at the end of the tunnel. There's a light at the end of the tunnel. I just need to find some direction. It's so cold, but God's my protection.
Good angle, Mike. This bad.
Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and you're probably wondering, Gurf, why did you do that? Why'd you do that? Do you really need attention that bad? Is this what your channel's turning into, a half-assed attempt at doing jackass stunts? No! And stop having opinions on me that differ from what I think about myself! You fucks! The reason I did that with the hammer is to make a point about people and the elections coming up and all the tension that's in the air. Listen, people, Donald Trump, Hillary Clinton, it doesn't matter who you're voting for. I'm voting for Donald Trump, not because I like him. In fact, I think he's an idiot, but because most of the people on my Facebook are voting for Hillary and I want to make them mad. By voting for Donald Trump. It's a personal funny thing. I personally hate Facebook. I think it's turned into a giant meme dumpster. And I've lost a lot of Facebook friends by doing things like voting for Donald Trump, things like that to piss them off. But anyways, the reason I hit my hand with that hammer... the reason I hit myself, my hand with that hammer is because I want to make a point about human beings as a whole. We only get one chance at living on Earth, okay? And we're all fighting with each other. That's all we do is we fight each other and we hurt each other's feelings and break each other's hearts. And it's time that we as a people start being friendly, more friendlier to each other. We only get one chance, okay? We only get one chance at life. So let's do it together as a team, okay? Let's put our cell phones down and breathe some fucking oxygen. Get your fucking eyes off that stupid fucking screen. The Pokemon aren't real. The Pokemon aren't real. I was walking down the street and this girl was playing Pokemon Go, right? And so I lunged at her. I didn't want to scare her, but obviously I did. And I was like, those Pokemon on your screen aren't real. I'm real. Pay attention to me. And she went over and she called the cops and it was a whole freaking thing. But I was trying to make a point. We need to put the cell phones down. We need to stop arguing on Facebook. If I could vote for Hillary and Trump, I would. I don't like either of them. You need to go outside, go to a stranger and shake his or her hand and say, God damn it, we're in this together. We as a people should be as one instead of five. Let's start getting along, okay? And don't leave mean messages on my YouTube videos like you're probably gonna do with this one. Just don't do it, okay? You know, there comes a time in your life where you're not a boy anymore, where you become a man. Or if you're like my ex-wife, you say, Gurf, when are you gonna become a man? And she'd lock me in the bathroom and hit me with clothes hangers. I wanted to call the cops, but I was afraid they were gonna laugh at me. It's not very manly to get beaten by your wife with clothes hangers. That's why I'm glad we divorced. I'm glad we divorced. It's a living. Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and this is a brand new episode of Gurf Fan Mail. This is a show where I answer questions from the fans. Before we start the video, make sure you go to cindyshade.bandcamp.com and download the brand new Cindy Shade EP that we just released 2 days ago. Just do it, okay? It's free. Alright, listen. If this is your first time visiting the channel, don't watch this video. This video is strictly for subscribers and Gurf fans. And I just came up with a name for Gurf fans. If you're a fan of Gurf Gurston, you are now a Gurfanite. That's what you're called. And if you don't like the name, well then go be a fan of somebody else. Because I came up with the name, and you are now a Gurfanite. Alright? And you're probably wondering, who has the audacity to tell their fans what to be called? Well, I do, because I worked too freaking hard on these stupid fucking videos to not tell my fans what to do. Someone needs to tell my fans how to live their lives. It sure as hell wasn't their parents growing up. Because look what they're watching. If this is your first time visiting the channel, don't watch this video. This video is strictly for fans. And this is going to be a very long video because I'm going to be answering a bunch of fan mail questions and I'm going to be going very in depth into my answers. This isn't like a comedy video. This isn't like Jay Leno, Louis Anderson comedy stuff. This is a show where I'm just going to straight up answer the questions as seriously as possible. You know what nostril style is? I'm not even gonna get into it. Okay, before I start answering the fan mail questions, I have a very, very big announcement to make. I, Gurf Gurston, just started last night writing my new book, That's right. It's going to be a physical book that you can purchase online. And it's going to have pictures of me. It's going to have words in it. And it's going to have true stories from my life. And you might learn something from it. Now, I know most of my fans are not the brightest people on the planet. And I think it's fair to guess that maybe 90% of my fans don't even know how to read. But there's pictures in it, as I just said. So, I should have the book done in a month, hopefully. But knowing me, I'll probably rush it and get it done in 3 days and then trick you guys. I mean, have you guys... Just buy the book when it comes out. I'll let you guys know. It's going to be called It's a Gurfy Life. All right, these are the questions. I got a whole bunch of them. So the first question is from P-Ball Playa 1440. If Gurf ever kills himself, how would he do it? I'd assume death by autoerotic asphyxiation, but who the hell knows? Well, that's a really fucked up question. If I were to kill myself, how would I do it? You know, I thought the internet was a place where people had some fucking manners, but they obviously don't. First of all, I would never, ever, ever kill myself. I've got too many things in my life that I need to get done. Too many goals. Too many motivationals. But if I were to kill myself, I'd probably slit my throat and, because I've always wondered what it would feel like to slit your throat and then push your head back and then feel the air coming out of your throat as you slowly die. But I would never do that. Next question. Azatur, that's the screen name, Azatur. More like as a turd. Dumb idiot. What kind of a screen name is that? I'm sorry. Azatur has three questions. I specifically said, that's one fucking question! But Asatura asked three questions, so I'm going to answer them. His first question is, what editing software do you use? Editing software, I use a program called Adobe Premiere. That's a great question to work an interesting answer out of. Boring question. The next question, are your videos shot on RED? If not, what do you shoot with? Another question I can't come up with a funny answer for. We shoot our videos on whatever we feel like. Right now I'm shooting on my cell phone, but we also have a DSLR 53087.5 camera. That's what we shoot our more artsy stuff with. It's a very nice camera that I need to get some new equipment, some new lenses for it. Sometimes we shoot on VHS. A lot of our stuff is animation, computer animation, which we make with a program that will remain nameless. We don't steal. Listen, this is an important point about this channel, and it's not a funny point. I'm not trying to be funny, but this is just me being me. Everything on this channel is 100% made from us. Okay, we're not like other people who use songs from real artists. We make all the music ourselves. We do all the animation ourselves. We don't take anything that from the internet unless it's royalty free. Like me and my cousin MCGG, we used to do reviews of public domain movies. That's all public. Everything on this channel is either made from scratch by us, Or it's some stock free stuff that is there's no copyright on it. This is very important because I see millions of YouTube channels and they're so lazy. They steal clips from real other movies. They steal clips from video games, like the computer animation stuff that we do for the Cindy Shade music videos. That's all from a program that I don't want to say what the program is, because then everyone will use it and it'll ruin everything. But it's all stuff that's custom made, royalty free, that we design, that we animate, pick the angles, we do all, everything on this channel is authentic, okay? And that's on it. That's a boring... Let's get on to another question. All right, the next question is from ProtoBaller1991. If you're a fan of my channel, I already answered a question from ProtoBaller1991 where I called his girlfriend. I was supposed to give the crystals back to the Dinosaur Kingdom and give them back to the Dinosaur King, and then the Princess of Sunland was supposed to give me a reward for doing this, and now I don't know where the crystals are, and you don't think my videos are funny, so now my whole day's ruined.
Yeah. You know, some people have bad days sometimes, though, you know?
Yeah, well...
bad. Sounds like you're having a bad day, but, you know, maybe your crystals will show up and you'll be able to deliver them back to the Queen of Sunland or whatever.
It's the Princess of Sunland. Please pay attention.
What is the Dragon Lord say?
That was a Gurfy classic, so I like the guy. Let's see what he has to ask. What camera do you shoot with? I already answered that. Do you use the mic built into the camera? Right now I'm using the cell phone mic, but usually we use an Audio Technica 2020. How was Gurf born? My mom shipped me out of her cunt. It's a silly question. How old is Gurf? I am not answering that. If you guys knew how old I was, you'd really think these videos are pathetic. Where did you get the beard from? What do you mean, where did I get the beard from? I grew it out. What do you think, we just CGI the beard in with editing? No, the beard is real. Okay, the next question is from Poopy PP. I'm not making that up, that's the guy's screen name. The guy's obviously in middle school. He asks, do you drugs? That's exactly how I asked it. Do you drugs? I'm assuming he's trying to ask if I do drugs. I don't do drugs anymore. I used to do drugs. I used to drink a lot. I'm sober now. Hopefully I stay that way. So I don't have to go to rehab again. I don't have a joke to make. I'm dead serious. I'm in recovery, so I don't do drugs and alcohol anymore, and I'm not going to get into that because I don't like putting my business all over the internet. Psychosphere asks, ever sucked one sweeter than mine? Yeah, I've sucked one sweeter than yours. So, bet you didn't think I'd have a funny answer for that one, did you? Fucking asshole. You know, I ask people to ask me fan mail questions and they can't take it seriously. It's, you know, it's like, grow up, guys. You know, think, really evaluate what you're doing with yourself in your life. That you have to go on the internet making an ass out of yourself like that. Aren't you embarrassed? So that's the answer to your question. Next question. Try Hard Nobody asks, would you rather fuck your mom in the ass or blow your dad? That's disgust. That's fucking disgusting. But if I had to do that, I'd probably blow my dad. Fright Train asks, in one of your videos, you said, that's my dad, and then stared into the camera without blinking for a very long time. Did you encounter nerve damage or some kind of paralysis? Fright Train is... I think he's asking about a video I made not long ago, Gurf's Movie Review 2, where I'll show a clip now, where I just stared into the camera for almost 2 minutes. That was all real, that was no trickery, I didn't blink, and you know, I never get enough credit for the physical things I do on this channel. Lately, I have been doing a lot of stuff where I've been hurting myself, where I stapled myself, where I burned my arm with a cigarette. And a lot of people said, hey, you didn't really burn your arm with a cigarette. Well, when did I film that? Was that like a month ago when I filmed that? And look, I'm still got the scars from it. And then there was another video where I hit my hand with a hammer. That was also real. Every time I do stuff like that, YouTube puts an age restriction on the video, which just makes the videos that much cooler. And a lot of people are like, Gurf, how do you, where did you come up with the idea to do all this crazy stuff to your body like that? And I'm like, I'm not afraid to live on the edge and to be edgy, man. Like, I'm not scared of getting hurt or anything. And I'm thinking of how awesome that would be if I could make a show where it would be just me and my friends, like, doing stuff to get hurt and stuff. Because that hasn't been done before, and I think it would make a lot of money. Zenny Gundam asks, at what point can one be considered an alcohol, and whatever happened to Uncle Larry? At what point can you be considered an alcohol? Like, when are you an alcohol and not just a person who drinks too much? One time, I got so drunk that I had sex with a couch. Does that make me an alcohol? Or did I just have too much to drink? No, I'm gonna let you guys dwell on that question. And by the way, I did not finish with that couch because my mom stopped me from finishing with the couch. Okay, the second part of his question, whatever happened to Uncle Larry? Uncle Larry, if you watch my videos, I used to spend a lot of my summers at my Uncle Larry's cabin. And I'm just gonna be straight up and not be subtle about it. He did stuff to my pooter. He did a lot of stuff to my pooter, and I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. If you watch my videos, you may have figured that out already, that he put things in there that shouldn't have fit in there. But I'm over that. It doesn't bother me anymore. Uncle Larry ended up spending a couple of years in jail for tax evasion. They had me testify in court when he was on trial for tax evasion, and I told them all about the stuff that Uncle Larry did to me, and they were just like, what does that have to do with tax evasion? And why would you admit that in the court? And the judge started laughing, which I thought was really unprofessional, because it was the first time I told anybody about that.
BuddyRow3 asks, Gurf, why don't you have a girlfriend?
Covered in Sponges asks, where do you people come up with these stupid screen names? Covered in Sponges asks, Gurf, what was your favorite part of my fan fiction series so far? I love this. You know, you tell people that you're going to answer their questions in a video on one of the most popular YouTube channels on the internet, and they always try to sneak some way to promote their fan fiction or their mixtape or something and take advantage of what you're doing. Well, Covered in Sponges, I'm gonna straight up answer you. I don't know who you are. I've never read your fan fiction, and I'm not going to. Listen, you couldn't pay me to read your stupid fan fiction. I don't read fan fiction because I'm not a nerd, okay? And to tell you the truth, I think nerds are fucking disgusting. Listen, I'm not a nerd, okay? I'm one of the cool guys. I've always been a cool kid. I've always wore backwards baseball hats. I've always worn sunglasses while riding a skateboard and playing electric guitar. That's the kind of dude I was. And I beat up all the nerds. So, Covered in Sponges, have fun doing your nerdy fan fiction. My name's Covered in Sponges, and I like to play with Star Wars action figures and do fan fictions. What an idiot. God, what a stupid idiot. What an idiot. Mixboy asks, how come we never see Gigi and Naven in your videos? He's asking about my cousin MC Gigi, who had a little bit of internet fame. Not many people know this, but if you YouTube a video called MC Gigi Music Video, which was made like 10 years ago, it has over 1 million views.
So MC Gigi had a little bit of notoriety. Now let me explain the MC Gigi thing. Because lately a lot of people have been asking me why he doesn't make videos on this channel anymore. MC Gigi's my cousin, okay? When this channel started, MC Gigi was supposed to be the star of the channel. He was like the mascot. But the people in charge of the channel realized, I guess, that like MC Gigi, he's like a one-note joke. So they fired him and hired me because they thought I was more interesting. Will MC Gigi ever come back to the channel? I hope not. I hope that answers your question. Again, Mixboy has two more questions. I specifically said to ask one question each. His second question is the woman whose hair you made that beard out of still a prisoner in your basement? I don't have a basement. Next question. When was the last time you washed that hat? This hat, as you know, I've always worn headgear in my videos. I used to wear a black baseball cap. Then I started wearing a black bandana. And now I pretty much have always worn this hat. I seriously haven't washed it since I started wearing it. I think I came back to doing videos 4 months ago, and I've always worn this hat since then because I got tired of trading out hats. And there's no reason to wash it. It's not like some chick came in and perioded on it, or my cat peed on it, or my dog took a dump on it. It's a clean hat. So don't worry about it. You know, I'm always a little suspicious about people who are too worried about washing clothes. I think they're a little, you know what I mean? People who wash clothes are a little, you know what I mean? They're just a little la-da-da-da, if you know what I mean. Trigun Bebop asks, what the fuck is a gurf and can I eat it? Yeah, you can eat my butt and eat all the poop from my butt and then swallow my poop and then poop out the poop after you digest it, you dumb fucking piece of shit. You know who I am. What, are you living under a rock? All right, last question. Thank God. So if you're still watching this video, I really commend you. I usually try to make my videos as short as possible. So if you're like watching right now, I'm proud of you. With the internet these days and cell phones, people's attention spans are so short. And I'm being serious right now. I'm not trying to be funny. People's attention spans are so short that it makes me worry about the next generation, because they can't sit through things. They go on Facebook, which is a meme dumpster, and it's all memes, pictures, and information. Now, 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 fast, fast, fast. Nobody takes the time to smell the roses and let things unfold. That's why I never finished making the Gurf movie, because I realized nobody's gonna sit and watch the damn thing. So, this is the final question. I know this hasn't been like the most clever video, but I promise my fans I do a fan mail video. I don't know if I'm even gonna go around promoting this one. I just wanted to do this just for the fans. This video is just for the fans. And I wanna say I really appreciate my fans before I answer this last question. But you guys have really been pissing me off lately. Like, you're not doing enough to support me. So I'm not really that appreciative of my fans. I think they could be doing a lot more to make me famouser and tell their friends about me. So if you're a fan of me, I don't appreciate you, and I'm a little mad at you. You guys need to work harder and spend more time watching my videos, commenting and subscribing and sharing them. Last question. Dear Gurf, the username is Six Claw Paw. He asks, Dear Gurf, hey, remember that time you got caught going bass to mouth with an underage fish? Or were you caught going ass to trout? First of all, no. I've never done any weird sex stuff with fish. Unless you're counting my ex-wife's vagina, which stank of tuna, like, all the time. I was like, Linda, you gonna clean that out? Like, at least attempt to clean it out? And she, you know, hit me with a wooden spoon or whatever was in the kitchen, and she beat me. She beat me so much, but I know she loved me.
Whether I like it or not, you're my son. So, since I'm stuck with you, stop fidgeting! Can you just stand still for 3 fucking seconds? Jesus Christ! You're such an invalid! You see, when a man loves a woman, like how I used to love my ex-wife, Linda, who... Interesting story about Linda. I remember one time, it was the middle of the night, and I woke up in bed next to Linda. See, Linda usually made me sleep on the couch, but I finally begged her, you know, to let us sleep in the same bed together. I mean, we were married. Why do I always gotta sleep on the couch, Linda? And so, anyway, I woke up in the middle of the night, and my penis was an excruciating pain. Really, just horrible pain. The worst pain you could imagine your penis being in. So I went to the bathroom, and I pulled my pants down, and I looked at my dick. And there were little cuts all over my dick. Not huge cuts. Little slivers. Little slivers. All over my penis. And I was like, oh, I don't know what's causing this. But this is obviously the reason why my penis hurts so much. So I started to think, you know, maybe spiders were biting me. But it couldn't have been spider bites. Because they were like little, you know, slivers. Little slivers and cuts. And, you know, me and Linda hadn't had sex in about 4 months, so it's not like she gave me an STD, which, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if she had STDs, you know, looking at the guys that she was fucking behind my back. Anyway, I put 2 and 2 together, and I figured out that Linda must have been doing this. So what I did is the next night, I pretended to be asleep, but I kept one eye open to see what Linda was up to. And sure enough, there she was with the little razor. She pulled my pants down, and I was still pretending to be asleep. And she put 3 little cuts on my dick. Now, since I was pretending to be asleep, I tried not to scream, which was hard. So, I don't know what she was doing it for. She wasn't, you know, putting huge cuts on my wiener. She was just doing little cuts. You know, just little tiny cuts, and she was laughing to herself like a demon cackles in the night. So the next morning, me and Linda were having our usual silent breakfast without eye contact, and I confronted her about it. I was like, you turned it up, hussy! Have you been putting cuts on my dick? You fucking two-bit dame! And then she started laughing and laughing and laughing and laughing, and I started getting madder and madder, and I started crying and crying. So I pulled my pants down, and I said, how could you do this? How could you do this to my cock? What did my cock ever do to you? What did I ever do to you except love you? And now you're taking razors and putting cuts in my dick. This is how you repay me for everything I've done for you. After I didn't tell your friends about your bowel obstruction, Linda. And she had a glass of lemon juice. And she proceeded to pour the lemon juice on my dick. And I screamed and screamed and screamed, son. I've just always... All I ever wanted was for someone to hold me and just tell me everything's gonna be okay. That's all I ever wanted. I never was asking for much. Just someone to hold me and tell me that the world isn't as horrible as it seems. Nobody ever did that for me. And don't think I'm gonna do that for you either.
Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and this is a video about police brutality and how I'm sick of it. How I'm sick and tired of the police brutalizing me and brutalizing the people of America. You cops are supposed to serve and protect me, and why are you going around brutalizing everybody with your power, with your abusive power? It's disgusting. It makes me sick. I'm so mad I could enter a vortex. Okay, so listen. So every Tuesday night, I like to go out on my front lawn at around midnight, you know, and I'd like to take out my chainsaw, and I like to rev it as loud as possible as a tribute to Michael Jackson, because I know Michael Jackson died a couple, like, years ago, but I'm still not over it, okay? I'm still not over the fact that Michael Jackson died. And so anyways, that's beside the point. Everyone misses Michael Jackson. So I like to go out on my lawn at midnight, Tuesday nights, and rev my chainsaw as loud as possible, and, you know, just blast some Michael Jackson on my stereo. I only do it for like 5 minutes at the most. But every time I do it, this stupid tramp lady neighbor calls my house and says, "Could you please stop revving your chainsaw at midnight every night?" And, you know, she always calls me in the morning when I'm not feeling well. And I'm like, "Listen, I'm not revving my chainsaw now. I was revving my chainsaw last night, ho. So, what are you gonna do about it?" So, the other night I was revving my chainsaw. It was midnight, and finally the lady neighbor comes out of her house, and I got so mad. I'm like, if she comes over to me, she better get her ass back inside her stupid house. But she comes over to me, and she's like screaming at me, right? Like really screaming at me, like, this chick has mental problems, man. She's like, "Could you please stop revving your chainsaw? It's midnight and my kids are asleep." And I was like, "Fuck your kids, lady. Tell your kids to get a job." And she's like, "My kids are 7 and 4. And I'm like, "Well, it's never too early for them to work." And so I didn't think anything of it. I just started revving my chainsaw louder and louder. And then wouldn't you know it, who pulls up to my house? A fucking pig. And by the way, pig is a slang that cool people use against the cops. We call them pigs. So the cop comes out of this car, and he comes up to me, and he's like, are we having a problem, sir? Are you revving your chainsaw at midnight and disturbing the peace?" So I'm like, the cop is like being all uppity about it. He's like, "Listen, you can't make noise like that when you rev your chainsaw at midnight." And then he was like, "Why are you using a chainsaw this late at night anyway? Are you on some type of drugs?" And I'm like, "What? I can't rev a chainsaw in the middle of the night without being on drugs or something? You gonna discriminate against me, cop? Gonna discriminate against me because I got a beard? Huh? You gonna make up laws to discriminate people? Huh? You fucking cop!" He comes up to me and I'm like, "Whoa, back off, man. Hey, back off. Take it easy. Take it easy, cop. Don't do anything crazy." And so, you know, he started getting in my face, right? And he's like, he moved in like an inch closer. He said, "Listen, all you need to do is go inside and stop revving your chainsaw at midnight and we won't have a problem." You know, and I'm like, "Fuck you, cop. You think just because you're wearing a badge, you can tell me to go inside when I don't feel like going inside? I got a sleeping problem, cop. I don't like going to bed at 12 o'clock. I'm sorry I'm not some nerd that goes to bed at normal hours." And I'm sorry I'm not some lame ass that only uses a chainsaw during the day. It's daytime out. I'm gonna use my chainsaw to cut down trees, but only in the day because I'm a pussy. Fucking cop. And so, you know, the cop, I was like looking at the cop like, are we done? Leave me alone. Don't you have other innocent people to brutalize? And the cop was like, you know, like, listen, I'm just asking you to go inside. I'm not gonna arrest you. And I was like, fuck you, cop. And then I took out my cell phone, right? And I should have been filming it. I don't know why I wasn't thinking about it, because if I had filmed it, this story would be all over the news already. But I pulled out my cell phone and I started, you know, I went on YouTube and I pulled up the song NWA, Fuck the Police. If you haven't heard of NWA, they're this underground rap group that only cool people know about from like the 80s. A lot of people haven't heard of them, or they haven't heard the song Fuck the Police. Only cool underground people like me know about it. But I pulled the song out and I started blasting it as loud as I could on my phone, which isn't that loud, and I started blasting Fuck the Police. Or I was going to. What happened was, it was a YouTube video of a song and an ad popped up. And then finally the song Fuck the Police played. And you know, he just kind of giggled a little bit. And said, that's very funny, and he actually laughed. He was actually a really nice guy, but I didn't care because he's a fucking cop. And I was like, fuck you, cop, don't laugh at the song. The song is about you and your police force brutalizing us innocents. And he's like, listen, I'm not trying to make a problem. And I was like, how do you talk with all those fucking donuts in your mouth? And he's like, I don't have any donuts in my mouth. And I was like, shut up, cop. And I went and I kicked him right in the shin. And guess what he did? He fucking tased me. He tased me, bruh. Cop tased me. I was lying on the ground and all my neighbors were watching by this point, and my neighbors said that I was on the ground crying, but I wasn't. It was just really windy out and the wind hit my eye. And you know, he took me to jail overnight, and the whole time I was in a jail cell saying, wait till you're so lucky I didn't get what you did on camera. Cause if I did, you guys would be in so much trouble. And then this really big other cop came in and really started yelling at me. And all the other guys that were, you know, in the holding cell with me said I was crying again, but I wasn't. It was just really windy in the cell. So that's my story about police brutality. If you got any stories about, you know, the punk-ass police brutalizing you for no reason other than that they're abusing their power, you know, leave it in the comment section or you know, do what you gotta do. But we as a people have to stand up and fight against these cops. This is Gurf Gurston signing off. Hey everybody, it's Gurf Gurston, and it's time for another episode of Gurf Sports Zone. This is a show where we talk about sports and other things of that nature. And I'm the expert on it, so I think it's Halloween season coming up, which means it's that spooky time for baseball season to start up. My favorite baseball team has been the Cardinal Niners. Ever since I was a kid, I was always a Cardinal Niners fan. I'd spend the weekends at my Uncle Larry's house. We'd watch Cardinal Niner games, and I'd be like, hey, Uncle Larry, can we play some baseball? And he said, we can't play baseball, but I got another game that we could play that involves balls and going into my shed. Baseball is a lot like sex. I never really understood it or ever got many chances to play it, or I never... No one would ever let me play. When I was a kid, there was a gang in my neighborhood called the Knuckle Boy Charlies, and they had their own little baseball league. And I always wanted to join their gang and play, you know, I don't know, I could be the quarterback or something. And I'd be like, hey guys, could I be the quarterback in your team? And they'd start laughing and laughing and laughing and beating me with bats. They beat me almost to
to the point where I started seeing my life flash before my eyes. And one of the kids tried to put one of those bats in my butt. And I wasn't having that. My butt wasn't ready for that. It'll never be ready for that. But I couldn't stop him. I mean, I was half unconscious and I've never walked the same way again. Oh, you know, when it comes to baseball and the Cardinal Niners, their defense really needs to, they really need to step it up a notch, you know what I mean? And their offense, they need to have more defense and they need to have more offense in all of their games. I mean, you're never going to get goals if you don't have the offense running that way. And you're never going to get defense. I mean, you're never going to get touchdowns if you don't have defense going for getting... There's one time I was at a bar and I got really drunk and there was this chick there. You know, she was nice, a little older than me. And, you know, we started flirting and I took her back to my place and, you know, was hoping we'd have sex. And, you know, she said, you know, I can't do it today, but maybe some other time. And I was like, listen, I really don't care about having sex. Could you just do me a favor? Could you fart on my pillow so I can smell it? Because I wanted to, you know, have the smell of her fart on my pillow so that when I slept it, it's just, okay, I'm weird, all right? I know it's weird. And she wouldn't even do that. She wouldn't even fart on the pillow. And I was like, please, please, I gotta get something out of this. I bought you all those drinks at the bar. And she was like, yeah, you're pathetic. You really make me sick. You're worse than my husband. And I gave her $50 to fart on my pillow, and she did. And I still have that pillow. I love you. You're the only girl that never was mean to me or called me a loser. Oh, I gotta call that girl back and pay her again. The smell's fading.
Alright everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and this is a very important video. Recently there's been some controversy about me. Some buffoon leaked a cell phone video that I made making fun of and insulting my fans.
Fans. You know, my fans are just, they're pathetic. I mean, they'll watch anything that I put out. You know, they're just dumb. I mean, they're part of American stupidity, most of them. They'll watch anything that you tell them to. My worst nightmare is, you know, meeting one of them. Could you imagine if I actually met one of my fans? That's like my nightmare. I have to talk to them. Talk to those idiots. Those dumb idiots. I wouldn't pee on a fire to put one of them out. I wouldn't give one of my fans a time of day like that. If I met one of my fans in real life, I'd probably, you know, just scoff at them, maybe spit on them. They're really scum. All of them.
Now, anyone who knows me and knows how decent of a person I am knows that I would never insult my fans. My fans are the most important people in the world to me. When I was in high school, no one would sit with me at my table. One day one of the lunch ladies came over to sit with me to make me feel better, and she started poking me and calling me prick boy, prick boy, little prick boy. When everybody in the cafeteria started laughing, look at Gurf, even a lunch lady makes fun of him. Fucking bitch. Now, I've watched the video. First of all, I don't think it's me talking because you don't see my face in a video. Second of all, if I did say that, and I'm not saying I did say that, but if I did say the things that were said in that video, they were taken out of context. When I said those things, that's not what I meant. But I didn't say those things. It was somebody else saying them. So when I was saying what I said in those videos, It was to take out context. This happens to every celebrity and every famous person on the planet.
Dude, you are not famous.
Shut the fuck up, Jeremy! Got the personality of a dead moth. Alvin, what are you doing here? It's time for your bleeding, boy!
Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston. Back in the day, there used to be a comedy duo called Cheech and Chong in the 40s. And they used to do a bit called Who's On First. It's a classic, classic comedy bit of confusion. So today, I thought in a tribute to classic comedy, me and my brother Jeremy would do our own version of Who's On First.
Ready? Okay.
So Jeremy, Who's on first base? Who's on first?
You mean like who's on first base? Like that, like the first.
You're not doing it right.
Baseball, right?
Just do it right. Do it the way we practice.
We never practiced.
God, you're like hanging out with like a broomstick or something. Have some personality. Come on, make this fun. I'm tired of doing all these videos by myself. And when I do videos with you, it's like I'm talking to a corpse or something. Ever since you... What happened to you in that fucking cornfield? You just have been so freaking weird ever since that incident happened. Anybody who come try to take my chainsaw and axes away, you come do that and I'm gonna cut you with them. Alright, let's look at some trees. Yeah, look at them. You picked some bad trees, huh? You had to get cut, didn't you? Because you was being a bad tree. You was walking around thinking that someone wasn't gonna come up and cut you with a chainsaw. But they did. They came up and they cut you down, didn't they, you bad little tree? I wonder, did they spank you before they cut you down, you stupid tree? Look at you. Look at you all cut up. You're gonna turn into a table. You stupid trees. Walking around like you're so important. Until you got cut by a lumberjack, didn't you? He came up with an axe and a chainsaw, and he said, "What do you want me to cut you with?" And you said, "I don't want to get cut." And he said, "Too fucking bad." And then he cut you down, didn't he? You stupid trees.
I mean, look, it's really simple, okay? There's two different types of people in this country.
There's the mean, scary, racist, homophobic, super religious people, right? Okay, that's one part of the country. And they're always angry. And then there's other people. There's the nice, not racist, not homophobic, not super religious people, right? And none of them can get along. We can't make a decision on who to make president because there's always one racist, homophobic, scary religious president running, and then there's always the other type of person running. So there's always going to be the same type of arguments, right? It's like, we can't make a decision, it's tearing my country apart. So, and I don't know why nobody's thought of this, why don't they just put those type, the scary, mean people on one side of the country, and they can have that side, and then put the nice people on another side of the country, and they can have that side. And just put like a wall up in the middle of the country, and then they can have that part of the country, and the other people can have that part of the country. It's not freaking rocket science. It would take, what, a week to build that wall? And then boom, nobody can complain because those type of people have their own part of the country and we have our own part of the country. It's not freaking rocket science. How come nobody running for president is even thinking about this?
You know, my dad always, he thinks he's such a tough guy, and he has all his friends over the other night to watch football, and you know, he's acting all tough and telling my mom, hey, go get me some more beer and spaghetti, and you know, he's acting all tough and cool in front of his friends. And then I came over and I turned the football game off and I put one of my videos on, and my dad got so embarrassed. And I was like, hey guys, look at what my dad's sperm created. He's kind of a loser, isn't he? Look at his son. Hey everybody, welcome to Gurf Commentaries. This is our Halloween special. I'm trying not to be too loud because I don't want to wake my girlfriend up. My two girlfriends in the other room. I don't want to wake them up, so I'm not being as loud as I could be. This is Gurf Commentaries. This is a show where me and a special guest do a commentary over a royalty-free movie. Tonight I will be joined by my special guest, Mike Marble. Mike, if you've watched my older videos, Mike was my old roommate that was always interrupting my videos with his wacky shenanigans. So I invited Mike over and we did a commentary over a little Halloween. Frickin', it's kind of like Mystery Science Theater, but not as clever or funny. So let's get you to the Halloween commentary. I hope you're not too scared. Make sure you check under your bed because the boogeyman might be there, or my Uncle Larry. I think that would be scarier than the boogeyman. He's up for parole. So if you know anybody who works in law enforcement, do whatever you can to keep him in jail. All right, let's roll.
Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston, and today we are going to be watching a Halloween Party. This is a royalty-free movie from the 50s or the 60s or something. So, you know, we're pretty clever guys. I'm here with my old roommate, Mike Marble. Mike used to help me with my older videos, you know, with editing and special effects. And we had a falling out. We both moved, and we haven't seen each other in a long time. And, Mike, introduce yourself.
My name's Mike Marble. I used to be Gurf's roommate. But we had a falling out. And we haven't seen each other in a long time. And, you know, we kind of talked over the phone. And now I'm here to help him do this little commentary.
Yeah, well,
I pretty much just said everything that you said. I mean, you pretty much just repeated everything I already said. It doesn't matter. Let's get to commentating on this fucking stupid-ass Halloween movie here. A bunch of kids and a family. The dad. There's a dad and a mom, and the dad's not beating the kids, so I don't know what kind of family this is supposed to be. It certainly wasn't like mine growing up.
You know, before we really get into this commentary, when we were talking on the phone, you asked me to do this. You know, I guess we kind of made up and everything, but you never really apologized. I mean, you didn't have to, but it's just, you know, goes with patterns of your behavior. You know, last time we saw each other, you were drunk. You know, I haven't really talked to my fans about my alcoholism. I've been sober 5 months now. My behavior that day was out of line, but I refuse to apologize to you, Mike. I refuse to apologize to someone like you who stinks of ham and cheese.
See, now, you didn't have to go and make fun. This is what I'm talking about. You can never just say something nice to me. This is the real forget about your drinking in the past. The real reason we don't hang out is because you can never say anything nice to me. You can never thank me for all the help I used to give you on your GURF videos. And to tell you the truth, your GURF videos haven't been good ever since I quit.
Listen, my GURF videos have been fantastic lately. Have you seen the numbers on them? Every single video I put out gets like 1,000 views.
1,000 in the long run, that really isn't a lot. I mean, when you look at like PewDiePie and Leafy is here and all those YouTube celebrities, they've got like millions of views for almost every darn near everyone, every single video that they ever put out. You're in the thousands. You're like a T-list celebrity. Those guys are A-list celebrities. And you know, the whole reason that, you know, you're not getting as many views as those guys is because your stuff's too weird. I'm always telling you to tone it down and to be more friendly. And, you know, maybe that's a reason why it's always so hard for you to find girlfriends, because you're creepy.
Oh, yeah. Mr., how old are you? 27 and still a virgin?
I am not a virgin. Yeah,
don't talk to me about girlfriends, you piece of shit. Why don't you suck my cock? Just get it over with. That's the whole reason you probably agreed to come over here, is because you thought you'd get a chance to suck it. But I'm not gonna let you do that. Maybe if you shaved your mustache that is barely grows in, maybe I'd let you then. But you brush your teeth. So go in my bathroom. Go shave that poor excuse for a mustache that you have, brush your teeth and come back here and you can gobble. You can gobble on it. You can gobble on my cock.
You know, you just haven't changed, Gurf. And you probably never will, and that's just sad. That's why your ex-wife left you. I'm gonna go. It was fun doing this commentary, even though we didn't even comment on the video at all. It's just sad. It's sad seeing someone that used to be a friend. You know, you think you'd change being sober, but you just haven't changed.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Just gobble on her. Gobble on it, Mike. Come on. I'll pull my pants down. Just give it a good old gobble. I don't need him. I don't need anybody. I've got my subscribers and my fans. And that's all I need. This is happy Halloween, everybody. This is my life. This is Gurf Gurston signing off.
Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston. I'm very, very sick. The doctor says I got a cold. My other doctor says it's AIDS. Which I don't know how that happened because I haven't had sex in 2 years. In two months. I'm very tired. And I don't know if I'm going to be able to make videos anymore. But that's okay. Because I've got a new message board. Gurfzone.boards.net. It's the bestest message board in the world, and I'm in charge of it. And if you want to come and wish me well, and wish me to get better, just join the forum. You can wish me well, or send me money, or you could post about whatever you want to post about, because it's a freedom of speech forum. I'm in charge, and the only way I'll ban you is if you make fun of me or say something that I disagree with. The reason I made a forum is because I got so tired of being banned from almost every single internet forum in existence. You name it, I've been banned. The bodybuilding forum, the Something Awful forum, where they hate me. The Rivals message board, I've been banned there 7 times. All for the simple crime of spam, of sharing my videos on these fine message boards. Moderators are basically, they were the nerds in high school that didn't have any friends. And they got bullied all the time. They got shoved into lockers. They got their books hit out of their hands. They probably got things put in their butt by some of the weirder bullies. And now they've grown up and become message board moderators, and they abuse their power. And if you join my message board, I won't do that. I won't abuse my power. But I will, seriously, if you say something that I think is controversial or that doesn't fit in with what I think, or you make fun of me, I will ban you. I mean, you can go in and make fun of everyone else, but don't make fun of me, okay? I've had enough of that in my life. Just quit being adult, okay? Quit being a buffoon. Just join my forum, okay? That way I don't look like an idiot having a forum where I'm just talking to myself like a buffoon. Okay, just join. It's free. You don't even have to join. You can just go in on as a guest and say stuff about people. And you could post threads about whatever you want to post threads about, as long as it's something that I agree with. Just do it, okay? I'm very sick, and this might be my last video for a long time. Because I got cold AIDS.
Hey everybody, this is Gurf Gurston. I'm under my covers right now because I have a story to tell, and it's a very traumatizing story. Last night I went on a date. I met this girl at the bookstore. I was looking for books about cheese, and she was hanging out in the same section, and I just said, screw it, would you like to go on a date with me to a movie? She was really cute, and her name was Stacy. And she said yes, and I was really surprised, because usually I have to beg women to go on dates with me, or give them offers of money to go on dates. So we went to the movies, and we sat next to each other. We were having a good time, and I got the nerve to put my arm around her. And halfway during the movie, She asked me if I wanted some popcorn. And she had the bag of popcorn sitting in her lap. And I reached in to grab some. And there was something in that bag. It was hard. And it felt like it had skin on it. That's when I realized it was her wiener. She must have put a hole in it and put her wiener in there, which is a trick I used to do in high school. But now it had been reversed and I was so confused. Why did she have a wiener?